Good morning, students. Let us move towards the another point, that is the Boyle's law of our new chapter, gas law. Now, as for the Boyle's law, in the last lecture we have seen the gas law. It is almost same. Here also we have to study about the nature of the gas. Okay, means but here the gas is known and there the gas is unknown. Now, what do you mean by Boyle's law? Boyle's law is nothing but the product of volume and pressure, the product of volume and pressure of a given mass of a dry gas where the temperature remains constant. Now here the statement is given, volume of a given mass of a dry gas is inversely proportional to the pressure at a constant temperature. Now suppose we have a gas and we have to take the two cases of the behavior in the two cases, case 1 and case 2. In the case 1, suppose the gas occupied the volume V1 when its pressure is P1. Okay, we will take the same gas, but in the first case, volume will remain V1 and pressure it will remain P1. Then what will happen? As per the law, volume is inversely proportional to pressure. And here constant is always remain, temperature is always remain constant. So, now we will remove this proportionality sign, then we have to put K over it. So volume is inversely proportional to pressure. Then what will happen if we cross multiply it? If here it remain 1, then what will happen? We will cross multiply it. So K will become P1 V1 and K is nothing but the constant. This is your first statement. In the second condition, where the gas volume will be V2, V2 is the volume occupied when the pressure P2. If the volume will become V2, then pressure automatically become P2. And here also the temperature remain constant. Means the temperature is same in both the cases. Then the same point will be there. Volume is inversely proportional to P, means pressure. So for removing this proportionality sign, what we will do? We will put here K. So V2 is inversely proportional to P2. And when we cross multiply it, so P2 is multiplied by V2, it will be remain constant. So this is your first equation, this is your second equation. When we compare the first and the second equation, it will become P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. And it is nothing but the constant. And in this situation, the temperature is remain constant. And this statement is only known as Boyle's law equation. So many a time in the exam they have asked the Boyle's law statement also. So the statement will be, the Boyle's law may also state the product of volume and pressure of a given mass of a dry gas at a constant temperature. The temperature is remain constant and the what is the most important, volume is inversely proportional to pressure. This law is also can be explained or verified with the help of some graphs that we will see now. Now this one is a graphical verification of the Boyle's law. As per the first impression, volume versus pressure will be there, where volume and pressure, they are inversely proportional to one another. Means if volume increase, pressure decrease. And if pressure increase, volume it will get decreased. So here we will draw one graph for that, x and y axis, where volume and pressure we have taken. Now if we increase the volume, the pressure it will get, means it will also reduce. And when we see the volume and pressure relationship, then with the help of this first result, it is very important that the graph is always be in a straight line passing through the origin. This is the first verification of the Boyle's law. In the second condition, volume versus pressure we have to take. And here what we will see, the hyperbolic curve with the first quadrant is obtained. As you know that in the graphs there are four quadrants, first, second, third, fourth. So here we will see hyperbolic curve in the first quadrant. And with the help of that, this is shown by this. Now here, on the one axis, we will take 1, 2, 3, 4. And the another axis, we will take x, 1, 2, 3, 4. And here, this is nothing but the volume and this is the pressure condition. Okay, volume and pressure condition is shown here. If as the volume increase, pressure is also increase. Why? Because both are the directly proportional to one another. And whenever volume and pressure are directly proportional to one another, it means it will give you hyperbolic curve. Here also temperature remain constant. In the third graph, it is shown where pressure volume versus pressure. Pressure volume versus pressure. It is nothing but a straight line obtained. Okay, which is parallel to the pressure axis. Now this is the pressure axis and this is pressure volume axis. Now here 1, 2, 3, 4, again we have taken the quadrant. Here also we have taken some numbers. And whenever we will draw a graph, pressure volume versus pressure, so it will always be remain a straight line parallel to the pressure axis. And it is only the verification for the Boyle's law. In the exam, Boyle's law and its mathematical expression always ask. This graphical verification is only for your understanding. Till then, children, good day.